It's no secret that NBA stars tend to live in extremely nice homes. It's also no big mystery why. These dudes make insane levels of dough. The most famous NBA stars that almost everyone could name off the top of their head are usually not only the highest paid players, but also the players with the most endorsement deals and signature products. It all pulls together to make them extremely valuable and extremely wealthy, and they're often not shy about it. Here are the most expensive mansions owned by NBA stars today that will completely blow your mind. Giannis Antetokounmpo. Say what you want about the Greek freak, but the dude seems like he's a genuinely humble guy. Even though he started out in the NBA making $22 million a year, unlike almost every other player on the planet, he didn't buy a new place right away. In fact, Giannis kept living in a rented two-bedroom apartment with his girlfriend, his younger brother, and his mom. It wasn't until a few years ago that Giannis eventually decided it was time to get a mansion of his own. Milwaukee, Wisconsin might not be the first place you think to look, but truth be told, like any major city, there are some absurdly expensive neighborhoods. Maybe the most expensive is River Hills. Big surprise, that's where Giannis decided to go. He purchased a 10,000 square foot palace, complete with 5 bedrooms, 7.5 bathrooms, a movie theater, a game room, and multiple swimming pools. The mansion also has a 2-story guest house. Before Giannis bought the property, it had been owned, funny enough, by another Bucks player named Mirza Teletovic. Teletovic and Giannis were teammates until Teletovic retired in 2018 and moved out of the country. For this enormous decked out property, Giannis shoveled out $1.8 million. That's of course an insane amount of money, way beyond the wildest dreams of 99% of people. But for Giannis, it was a bargain, and as far as NBA mansions go, it's actually kind of on the low end. As far as we know, Giannis is still living here with his family. There's been talk over recent years about the two-time MVP possibly looking to take his talents to another city, but so far, it hasn't happened. In fact, just this past December, Giannis re-signed with the Bucks for a 5-year extension. This super max extension made headlines around the sports world for being the most expensive contract ever signed in NBA history. Giannis is now getting paid well over $45 million a year to play for Milwaukee. Does this mean we'll see Giannis move yet again? Maybe another upgrade is in store for the MVP. There's no doubt he could afford something much bigger and more expensive even in the crazy huge mansion he already has. It's really just a question of whether the Greek freak wants to move or not. Kevin Durant. Prior to signing with the Brooklyn Nets in 2019, Kevin Durant lived in Oakland. In addition to being the former hometown of the Warriors, Oakland is famous for being the most dangerous city in California. Several NBA players, including Damian Lillard, grew up there and have spoken publicly about some of the rough neighborhoods and violence on the streets. But that's not the Oakland KD was living in. Durant was among the few who could afford to look down on the sprawling masses from the safety of the surrounding hillside. Oakland Hills, just like Beverly Hills, is an unimaginably expensive area full of mansions most people will never see in their lives. The only way you're gonna buy a house up there is if you're a multimillionaire and then some. Luckily for KD, he definitely was. The Warriors were paying him a staggering $41 million a year, and his net worth is estimated at $170 million. The top real estate agents in the Bay Area are probably more than happy to give Durant the full tour and show him all the craziest available properties in the area. KD settled on a mansion in Oakland Hills that fills up more than 9,000 square feet of the luxurious Ridgemont neighborhood. The home has 7 bedrooms and 8 bathrooms. The views are insane, and the house has a huge balcony looking out on the bay too. Oh, and of course, there's a basketball court. To call this ridiculous palace in one of the world's most expensive real estate markets his own, Durant had to dish out $6 million. That's a lot more money than the average American makes in their lifetime put together, but for Durant, it was only about 15% of his Warriors paycheck. And that's not including the fact that he has signature sneakers, numerous brand deals, and not least of all, he's a serious investor in Silicon Valley. The truth is, Durant probably could have purchased a home several times bigger and more expensive than this one, as mind-boggling as that is to think about. Of course, he doesn't live there anymore, and who knows what his place in Brooklyn looks like. James Harden. The San Francisco Bay is probably the most expensive place to buy a house in the entire country, but Houston, Texas is a different story. For KD's teammate James Harden, a whole world of opportunity opened up after the Houston Rockets gave him the most expensive player contract in history at the time, damn near $43 million a year. Back when the contract was announced, Rockets owner Leslie Alexander said something hella funny. Since he arrived in Houston, James has exhibited the incredible work ethic, desire to win, and passion to be the best that has made him one of the most unique and talented superstars in the history of the game. Additionally, the commitment he has shown to our organization, the city of Houston, and Rockets fans all over the world makes him a perfect leader in our pursuit of another championship. Ouch. That was in the summer of 2017. To be fair, in the 2017-2018 season, the Rockets were the best team in the NBA, and they came seriously close to beating the Warriors in the Western Conference Finals, but they didn't. That commitment to the city of Houston and Rockets fans all over the world suddenly and mysteriously vanished. And of course, Harden went on to refuse a staggering $50 million a year offer before leaving for Brooklyn. But before all that went down, Harden took advantage of his status as the league's highest paid player and bought a completely over-the-top mansion in Houston. Remember how I said KD's mansion was over 9,000 square feet? Well, this one is over 26,000 square feet. The mansion Harden picked is so fancy, it has a name, Memorial Modern. Memorial Modern is located in Rivercrest, which as you could probably guess, is a stupid expensive neighborhood in West Houston. This mansion had just about everything you could think of. A massive swimming pool, a massive kitchen, a private bar, a movie theater, a shower bigger than a lot of people's apartments, and of course, a gated entrance with a circular driveway, just like any typical rich person in a movie would have. The mansion was designed and built by a company called Frankel. According to their website, this particular mansion is unique because it's so large, yet maintains a minimalist style. It also took them 3 years to complete. It took Harden much less time than that to decide this was where he wanted to live. He coughed up $10 million for it, sacrificing less than a quarter of his Rockets salary. It's a crazy thing about wealth that a lot of these guys end up paying for things only they could afford, yet they could have still afforded something several times more expensive. Anyway, spoiler alert, Harden didn't stay that long. In January of 2021, he packed up and headed off to join KD and Kyrie in Brooklyn. It's unknown whether his former home, Memorial Modern, is still on the market or if some other insanely rich person has moved into it. All I know is, you and I ain't going anytime soon either way. Steph Curry. So far, we've looked at some seriously expensive and rare mansions that only a handful of NBA stars could pay for. But this is where things really start to get blown into outer space. Steph Curry is right up there with Harden, Giannis, and KD when it comes to earning over $40 million a year from his contract. But Steph is also a generational player who has transformed the game in a way very, very few players have. This means Steph has a unique opportunity to make money other ways. Brands flock to work with him because he's not just a famous NBA star, he's a full-blown icon. Steph's annual income is estimated to be as high as twice his NBA contract, and that's not to mention the fact that his wife is also a very successful businesswoman, making boatloads of cash too. In the summer of 2019, after a disappointing loss to the Raptors in the NBA Finals, rumors were swirling about the Warriors dynasty being over. KD left, Klay was out with a serious injury, Curry, on the other hand, wasn't going anywhere, and he used the offseason as an opportunity to buy a house that's almost literally unbelievable, it's so fancy. Harden thought he was breaking the bank at $10 million, but tell that to Curry, he'd probably laugh out loud. This straight-up castle in Atherton, California, cost Steph no less than $31 million. The reason for the move was probably because this was the same year that the Warriors left Oracle Arena for the Chase Center on the other side of the bay. Atherton is a small town about 30 miles south of San Francisco, and according to Forbes, it is the most expensive zip code in the United States. Tons of other rich famous people also live there, including 49ers superstar receiver Jerry Rice. Despite this, when Curry made his $31 million purchase, it became the most expensive real estate purchase in the history of the Bay Area, a market which, as I mentioned before, is notoriously pricey. This is a house that makes the neighbors jealous, even in Atherton. The house was reportedly never on the market publicly. Who knows how Curry even got it, or who connected him to it. But it's amazing to think even if you had $31 million just lying around, you still wouldn't have been able to buy this place. Crazier still is the fact that, in order to protect his family's privacy, the house is almost impossible to actually see. We can all figure out roughly where it is, because Atherton is a small neighborhood, but the mansion is so tucked away and protected by security that very few photos even exist of the place. We don't know how many bedrooms or bathrooms there are, we don't know what the swimming pool situation is, or the basketball court situation. Do the Currys have a movie theater like at Harden's pad in Houston? Is there an amazing view like KD's mansion in Oakland? No idea. The whole place is simply off limits for regular people. But use your imagination. If Harden bought his 26,000 square foot place for $10 million, what does $31 million get you? I can't believe I'm saying this, but it gets more expensive than even Steph Curry's Atherton mansion. How is it even possible, you might ask, when Atherton is the most expensive zip code in the United States? Well, just because Atherton is the most expensive area overall, doesn't mean it has every single expensive property. And just because Steph is a generation-defining athlete worth hundreds of millions, doesn't mean he's the biggest or wealthiest star in the NBA. In fact, he's not even close. I know I don't need to tell you who I'm talking about. LeBron James is in a league of his own. It's been estimated that when he retires, James could quickly become only the second NBA star in history to be a billionaire. As things stand right now, he's the richest NBA player by an extraordinary distance. When you put all the contracts he signed in his career together, he's the highest paid player in NBA history overall. And of course, don't get me started on the kinds of brand deals James has racked up. The guy has even been in movies, and I'm not talking little guest appearances that give him one paycheck. I'm talking starring roles in major Hollywood motion pictures. Imagine being a lead actor in Hollywood and being an NBA star. That's a level of wealth and success that just can't be properly described. James has so much money, his life has to be run like he's a company. He has a team of financial advisors. He has a whole staff of employees who live at his house, cleaning, cooking meals, providing fitness training for him, and who knows what else. LeBron also wins the grand prize for having by far the most expensive housing on this list. In 2020, James paid $39 million for a Beverly Hills mansion that's just stupid, it's so nice. The property is 13,000 square feet and was built all the way back in the 1930s, meaning the history of celebrities who have lived there is long and full of recognizable names. For a gigantic investment, LeBron and his family are rewarded with 4 bedrooms, 7 bathrooms, a movie theater, and a full tennis court. Giannis also might get jealous, because although his place has a pretty nice guest house, LeBron's place has 2. But here's the part that's really gonna make your jaw drop. This property is gonna end up costing way more than $39 million. LeBron is likely to spend millions and millions more because he's having the whole thing torn down and rebuilt so it can be even bigger. And what will King James do while his house is being completely demolished and rebuilt from the ground up? Well, he and his family will go live in one of his other houses, of course. LeBron has 2 other mansions. One is in his hometown of Akron, Ohio, and another is just 5 miles away from Beverly Hills in a similarly upscale neighborhood of Brentwood. I guess it just goes to show when you're that wealthy, the world operates by different rules.